Hey everybody, this is Dr. Paul Thomas, and while I'm not a policy expert, I did want to talk about the changes that might be happening in 2025 and beyond regarding a new presidential administration. As you may know, Donald Trump was elected president recently, and so let's give a state of where we are and what might happen. So currently the ACA, or Affordable Care Act, is in place, and currently only 8% of Americans are uninsured. Before the ACA went into place, 17% of Americans were uninsured. And so the Affordable Care Act, or the ACA, allowed for people to get expanded coverage. And one of the ways that the federal government did that is by giving subsidies to families and individuals to buy a health insurance plan, right? So they're called premium subsidies or enhanced subsidies. And if you're an individual that makes $60,000 a year, you probably pay about $425 a month for your health insurance. Without the subsidy, that price would be $539 a month. And then for a family of four that makes about $120,000 a year, they typically pay about $850 for the subsidy, or for health insurance. And without the subsidy, that cost could be $1,649 a month. So the price would basically double for a family of four without that subsidy. So one of the ways to reduce federal spending, give people tax breaks, is to cut back on federal programs like the Affordable Care Act subsidies and Medicaid, which is the next topic. Actually, ACA subsidies cost about $335 billion over the next 10 years. So they kind of amortize that amount over a 10-year period. So if those subsidies expire, they would expire at the end of 2025, and it would really affect people going into 2026. So the subsidies were part of some of the COVID relief programming, and so that will expire at the end of 2025. So if those subsidies were to expire, 3.8 million people are estimated to lose health insurance coverage, because most families wouldn't be able to justify going from $850 a month to $1,649 a month for their health insurance coverage. The other target of the federal government to, again, cut spending, maybe give tax breaks or lower taxes, would be on Medicaid costs, right? So currently the federal government spent, in 2023, the federal government spent $616 billion on Medicaid. That was in 2023. As a comparison, the Pentagon budget, or military defense spending, was $820 billion. In 2023. So the federal government could pull back spending on Medicaid as a way of saving money or reducing the deficit or giving a tax break to Americans. The federal government matches states up to 50% or more when the state decides to spend on Medicaid. So for example, in Michigan, we've adopted the Medicaid expansion, and that's supported in part by the federal government. So we spend money to help unemployed or underemployed folks qualify for Medicaid. The cutoff for Michigan is $17,000. If you make less than $17,000 in the state of Michigan, you qualify for Medicaid as an individual. If you're a family of two or three, it's like $24,000. If you make over $24,000, you're disqualified for Medicaid. I think a family of four, it's like $36,000. So if you make over $36,000 as a family of four, you're disqualified from Medicaid, right? So these subsidies help people afford, you know, help our state pay for Medicaid in Michigan. We get some of those subsidies from the federal government, so like 50% of the cost. So if the federal government pulls back, then we'd have more folks who should qualify for Medicaid disqualified for Medicaid, if that makes sense, because we can't afford it as a state. All right, the other ways that your medical care could change in 2024 and into 2025 is, right now the federal government is now able to negotiate on behalf of Medicare to lower the cost of prescription drugs, and that could change if the federal government decides that they no longer want to lower the cost of Medicare eligible folks' prescription drug costs. So you could see that change happening in 2025 and 2026. That's all I got for today. It's a little bit of a complicated subject, but a lot of people are wondering what's going to happen to the ACA now that Trump is going to be president in January, and what's going to happen to Medicaid subsidies. My guess is that the Trump administration will pull back on enhanced subsidies for individuals to buy from the ACA, and they're also going to pull back from supplementing states and their ability to pay for Medicaid on a state-by-state basis. So we're going to see more people become uninsured in 2025 and 2026. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.